The wedding was so special.
Oh, I wish that too, Celia.
No, I'd like to see pictures of those people in those gay 90s outfits.
You should have seen Edward.
Oh.
I want to see those pictures, too. They should be ready by the time we get back to Port Charles. Holly, Jimmy Lee gave me the most beautiful diamond and pearl choker you've ever seen in your life. Mm. I was going to wear an heirloom that Felicia had from her grandmother, but...
Bert, that necklace and the bracelet, were they part of Sean's stolen treasure?
Yes, Felicia had to get them back from you so that Anna could give them to Sean and make him believe that she's on his team.
I don't believe it. Frisco and Felicia were involved, too. I was completely in the dark.
No more than I was until I was kidnapped. When I think of all those terrible things I said to Anna and to Robert.
Well, he felt the less you knew, the safer you'd be.
Well, I know that now, but...
I said some pretty awful things, too, to both of them.
Let's hope we both have the chance to apologize.
Mrs. Scorpio, the doctor says you can leave the hospital as soon as he signs a release form.
Oh, that's fantastic. Did you make the reservations at the hotel, Bert?
Yes, it's all taken care of. If you're sure you don't want to go back to Port Charles.
Oh, absolutely. I want to stay right here. As close as I can to Robert.
Are you sure you're up to leaving the hospital? Your ankle is still very swollen.
I'm fine, Senior.
Well, you don't look fine. You look like you're in pain.
It doesn't hurt that much. Besides, I can stay off the ankle once we get to the hotel.
Maybe we should go back to Port Charles. We have no idea of knowing how long it'll take Robert once he gets...
Celia, I'm staying here in Borderville for however long it takes.
All right. I know there's no sense in arguing with you once you get that stubborn set to your chin.
What in the world can be taking them that long?
I don't know. Maybe he was busy.
Too busy for a signature?
You know hospitals and paperwork. I'm sure Bert is trying to hurry them up.
I'm not so sure of that. I think he'd prefer if they kept me here.
I agree with him.
But I can't know anything that's going on if I'm cooped up in here. I want to know exactly when Robert contacts Bert so I can get to him right away.
You're worried sick about him, aren't you?
I'm petrified. But I know Robert has to see this thing through.
I still don't understand this. I thought that Robert and Sean were such close friends.
They were once. I think that's what's hurt Robert the most, is being betrayed by a friend.
He must have felt doubly betrayed when he found out that Grant was working with Sean.
Yes. He told me he was devastated, knowing that Sean was involved in Tony's shooting, and then me leaving him because of Anna, and then finding out that one of his closest friends in Port Charles had gone over to Sean's side.
Oh, he must have felt so alone.
Yeah, I know he did. Well, thank goodness Grant didn't really betray him. In fact, Grant proved himself to be a better friend even than before by helping him so much on the train.
This is all so unbelievable. There we were having such a wonderful time on the train, not even suspecting that all this intrigue was going on.
Until... Holly, did you know that that scar on Anna's face is fake?
Yes, I did know. In fact, I found out just before I left Port Charles. It was one of the reasons why I left.
How did you know? Well, we were having a little picnic in one of the towns on the train route, and Robert and Anna were having a terrible fight, and he grabbed the scar and ripped it off of her face in front of everyone.
Oh, no, poor Anna.
Why would he do something like that?
It may have been for Sean's benefit. Bert was telling me that they had to make him believe that Anna didn't want anything more to do with Robert.
Well, do you know why she was wearing that scar in the first place?
She said it had something to do with doing penance for something that had happened in the past. I didn't hear what she was saying. I was just too convinced that she and Robert were having an affair.
Holly, you can't blame yourself for having feelings like that.
Robert asked me to trust him. I should have trusted him.
And you have no reason at all to suspect them?
No. I'm sure of it now. And I'm going to spend the rest of my life making it up to Robert. You know, for not believing in him.
Mrs. Scorpio, the doctor has signed your release.
Oh, fantastic. Let's get out of here.
Better stay where you are a little longer. There's still the matter of the bill. But Captain Ramsey's taking care of it right now.
Thank you.
He should be up soon.
But, trust the release and the bill. I think this is some plot to keep me here.
Holly, relax. We're going to get out of here very soon.
You don't have to stay with me. You should be with your new husband.
I want to stay.
Yeah, but there's no need. Bert can stay with me, and I'm fine now.
Holly, I can be every bit as stubborn as you can be. And I'm going to stay here until you and Robert are back together again. For good?
Holly, I was downstairs and I took care of the bill, so everything,
Bert,
whenever you...
Robert, coming over.
Oh, that's Robert. Yes, Robert, where are you? What's happening?
I'm in the vicinity of Wu's shell and I found the treasure. Over.
Hey, that's great. Now, what do you want me to do?
Just sit tight. I can't talk long. Sean's men have been out patrolling the woods. I'm going to take the first tram I can get to Borderville to get the second phase of the plan underway. Now, I'll contact you at the hotel. I'm going to get this treasure covered before someone comes along.
Over and out.
Bert, I wanted to speak to him.
Well, Holly heard what he said. He's working against time. It'd be dangerous to call him back.
But he's all alone out there. You should do something to help him.
Holly, I can't go charging up there and blow his cover. He wants to catch Sean with that treasure.
I don't give a damn about the treasure. You've got to do something
Holly.
To help
Holly.
Him.
Holly,
this is crazy. This is absolutely insane. You should never have let him go up there alone. If anything happens to him, I'll blame you. You realize that, don't you, Bert?
Holly, calm down.
I'm not going to lose him now. I couldn't stand to. If you're not going to do anything to help him, then I
will. Holly, please.
Stop it.
Holly, please. Please, There is absolutely nothing you can do. Get the doctor in here quick. Holly.
Sedative the doctor ordered. You're in a weakened condition, Mrs. Scorpio. You should try to avoid stress for the next few days.
Avoid stress? I've got to get out of here. I want to find my husband.
Holly, you're not going anywhere until you calm down. This should take effect in a few minutes.
I want to find Robert. I can't stand just sitting around here.
Holly, the doctors say that they don't need this room for a while, and they want you to just lie there and rest.
I don't want to rest.
Oh, well, I don't think you have much choice. I'm really not sure you should even be leaving the hospital so soon.
But what's happening with Robert? Have you heard from him again?
No, nothing.
Can't you raise him on the walkie-talkie?
Holly, I told you that that would be dangerous.
Well, we can't just sit here and do nothing. He needs help.
We don't know that, Holly. Robert said that he'd take the next tram back down here and he'd contact me at the hotel.
But he said Sean's men are everywhere.
No, he did not. He only said that his men are patrolling the woods.
And you heard his voice? It didn't sound as though he were in any immediate danger.
No, but you know Robert. He always sounds so bloody cool, no matter what's going on.
I know Robert, and I know that he's not going to try to play super cop. If he's in trouble, he'll call me, Holly.
What if he can't? What if Sean's already
got
him? Now,
Holly, that doctor is about 2 seconds away from bringing you back in this hospital to stay. Now, if you do want to get out of here, you better stop thinking the worst and stop getting yourself so upset.
Bert's right, Holly. Try to stop worrying. Robert is probably on that tram right now.
Thank you.
enough. Can we go now?
Are you sure? Maybe you should sleep a little.
No, I want to get out of here.
No more shenanigans?
No, no more, I promise.
Okay, but if you do act up, I promise you, I personally will carry you back here and turn you over to Dr. Landrino.
I said I promise. Now, can we go?
How's your ankle?
It's fine. I can't even feel it.
I don't know if that's good or bad.
I think it's probably just a sedative, Bert.
I know I dozed off. Have you heard anything more from Robert?
No, not yet. Remember what I said, Holly. No news is good news.
I hope you're right.
I'm sure he's going to be all right, Holly. What's the matter?
I don't know. Someone just walked over my grave.
Yeah, it's a great country.
I think Jimmy Lee and I should have come here for our honeymoon.
I still feel really awful about dragging you away from your honeymoon.
Holly,
it wasn't you. It was Robert who asked me to call Celia.
Right. And you don't feel one bit bad, do you, Bert?
Maybe a little bit.
Jimmy Lee was so glad to get off that ship. It was rocking like a rocking horse. It was green.
You could have stayed in Bermuda for the rest of your honeymoon.
Okay. Both of you, get something straight, please. I didn't hesitate one second in coming here. I wanted to be with you.
I wonder where Robert is.
I think I'll order some tea.
Good idea.
Bert,
Where
do you think Robert is?
I'm not sure, Holly. Perhaps Canada.
He seems nearby.
Well, you can be certain of that. The Canadian border is right here.
Well, the tea will be right up.
Thanks.
Oh, the countryside. Funny, but it reminds me of my first honeymoon.
That's right, you went skiing. Not only did I prevent you from enjoying your second honeymoon, but your first wasn't.
Now, Holly, stop it. I think that's when I loved Grant the most.
Is it really over?
Yes, it's over. I love Jimmy Lee.
You know, I'd just like to have one honeymoon with Robert.
Well, that's right, you never had one.
No, we just sort of slipped into love. But it turned into a really deep emotion.
An emotion you'll have for the rest of your lives. Oh, what's wrong? Did I say something?
No, I'm fine. Sorry.
Holly, you may want to rest for a little while, huh?
Really, Bert? No, I feel fine. I feel alive and well knowing that I'm close to Robert.
It's funny. A little while ago, that countryside reminded me of Grant. Now all I can think of is Jimmy Lee.
Sorry?
That's okay. I know you just have one thing on your mind, too. Robert's safety.
He'll be all right, Holly.
How can you be so sure?
Because I know your husband.
How'd you get over the border?
Well, there are two ways. The long way, back roads that are built like a corkscrew. I've got men on their way up there now.
Oh, so you haven't left Robert stranded.
Now, you know I'd never do that.
What's the other way, the short way?
To Canada?
Yes.
The Rialto Tram.
Tram? Is that safe?
As safe as a baby in its mother's arms.
Or as a husband in his wife's arms.
I hope you're right. Please let Robert be that safe.
Thank you.